guys, what's up? This is Blaze the Movie Fan, and thanks to Chris Stockman, I was introduced to two great movies. Earlier this month, I reviewed Seven Samurai, and now I'm reviewing City Lights. By the way, after you're done watching this review, I highly recommend you check out Chris Stockman's review of the same movie. Because his review is very informative. Anyway, Charlie Chaplin is one of the most important actors in movie history, and that's not an opinion, that's a fact. There are very few people that will be remembered even long after their deaths, and Charlie Chaplin is one of those people. He has made many great movies in his career, one of which is the movie that I'm going to talk about today, and that movie is City Lights. Now before I talk about the movie itself, I just want to say that I appreciate silent movies. I don't love that style of movie making. I personally prefer movies with speed, but I still appreciate silent movies since they are an important part of movie history. Now normally I would explain what the movie is about, but to be honest there isn't much of a story. But more on that later. I'm first going to talk about the characters. I'm going to start by talking about the tramp played by Charlie Chaplin. Now this guy is a goofball, that goes without saying. He does goofy things throughout the movie. But at the same time though, he is still a very good guy. Yeah, he is a good guy with good intentions and his heart sure is in the right place. And to be honest, I feel sorry for that guy. Now the next character that I'm going to talk about is a blind girl played by Virginia Cherrell. Yeah, not a single one of the characters of the movie actually has a name. At least according to Wikipedia. Wikipedia doesn't list any of the characters' names. I don't know why. Usually the Wikipedia article has that information. But the Wikipedia article for City Lights doesn't for some reason. Anyway, she is a beautiful, wonderful girl. And I mean both by looks and personality wise. Nothing more needs to be said. Now the third and final character that I want to talk about is eccentric millionaire played by Harry Myers. Now this actor reminds me of a certain modern actor. I don't know who the hell that is, but he does remind me of a modern actor. But I honestly don't fucking remember the name of the movies that actor was in. Anyway, by the beginning of the movie, this guy is suicidal. Damn, that's dark. That poor guy. Yeah, for a movie that's a comedy, this year is dark for that. And the fact that he is suicidal is even taken seriously. And he is also a very good friend of the tramp. Now it's time to talk about the comedy, and that's where this movie really shines. I remember earlier on in the video when I said that this movie doesn't have much of a story. Well, the reason for that is because this movie focuses more on goofy moments than it focuses on story. Which, mind you, is not a bad thing. This is a comedy movie after all, and the main purpose of a comedy movie is to make you laugh. And to be entirely honest with you, this movie really fucking does. I was laughing my ass off throughout the movie. Which isn't that surprising considering that Charlie Chaplin was a comedic genius. But there is one problem that I have with this movie though. Why doesn't the butler of the mansion want the tramp in the mansion at all? I mean seriously, his beef with him makes no sense and it's never really explained in the movie. It's a minor complaint of an overall great movie. Well, it's time for my overall thoughts. Now, I don't hold this movie in as much high regards as Chris Stockman does. I mean, it's a great movie, but it's nowhere near one of Charlie Chaplin's best, in my opinion. With that being said, it doesn't change my opinion that this movie is fucking great. And for that, I'm of course going to give the rating 2 thumbs up. Thank you, Chris Stockman. Thank you. I'm sure you will introduce me to many more great movies in the future. Well guys, that's all I wanted to say. Thank you for watching and have a great day.